It's June the 30th, 2014. My name is Dana Vermfort, and we are beaming live onto YouTube at Beautiful Girl by Dana, or anywhere else that it happens to show up. And we are happy to see other people uploading the videos, because that way we know that the information is actually getting out there a little bit. And to so many people out there, there's major links below me of people that are working non-stop, long before I even started on this road here, putting videos up with all kinds of narratives from all over the world, from all the experts. We cover thousands and thousands and thousands of headlines on this site. It's getting close to 9,000, I would imagine, at this stage. Tonight we're covering Fukushima. I gotta get rid of that one here. Fukushima drove the World Nuclear Association to lie, and then lie some more. And then they got up, had some coffee, and they lied all day, that day too. And then they went to bed, and they got up, and then they lied. And I got a thing here from Google telling me they don't like my key frequency rate. So let's go over and check the video, see if everybody's yelling at me. I've never seen this one before, so... How is this, folks? I'm going to hang on and see what she says. Is that stream okay like that? Google is saying it's all screwy. It looked pretty good there. And what do you guys say I should do? Should I keep doing what I'm doing here? Should I restart and try to fix it? I don't know, Roger. That's the question. Hi, Stacy. Tom. Cats Alive. Rick Robinson. War Prophet. Albert. Foggy Range, Chris Barton, Cats Alive, Lori, Roosevelt, Kevin Kane, Pasha, Tom, MSVS, Taxi, Illusion is Over, Burnt Smell? You said, you'll share your ice cream, you got Ben and Jerry. Ben and Jerry actually is announcing that they got almost all the GMO out of their product now.
Yeah, they announced that about a year ago.
They were going to do it. And just a week ago, they announced you got, I think, hi, Kate. And you'll find links below to Kate, Fukushima Hounds. And Kate's got some videos up there. You should check out where she's made herself. And let me see. How was the audio? How's the video? Sounds good. And that's for art. Punisher. Foot, thank you for your offers to go fly me down to Florida. You're very kind. Unfortunately, I can't travel because of my health. And that's a huge issue, but... hi, Jeff. JLWFTL. I can't... That's not a word. That's just somebody went like that, I guess. Starlight. Pasha. Everybody streams okay. Lunar. So everybody's saying the same thing. Smell. Candace says it looks good. Audio. Lori, everybody's good. Okay. Nip Killer. Hi, Dyke. Quan Dyke. Time is true. Man, we got a lot of you guys in here tonight, haven't we? Okay. Okay, I sound fine everywhere except for here. Right, Raj?
Yeah. it's terrible here. My ears are bleeding.
Well, I can't say much when it's the truth. My voice is really rough. That's okay. That's okay. I don't need two lungs. So the World Nuclear Association. A bit of a tongue twister. World Nuclear Association covers about 85%, 95% of all the nuclear outside of America. Right? And so they're a membership. They're a non-profit. And they set a lot of policies. But they're not powerful.
And they're non-profit.
And they don't tell the truth. But anyway, you got a disclaimer there that if you want to use material from their site, like we're doing tonight, you must not do or omit to do anything which may weaken, damage, or be detrimental to the World Nuclear Association, trademark, goodwill. Or a reputation.
Oh, God. That's leaving yourself wide open, isn't it?
No, not really.
What it is.
Well, when the video, by the time it gets to the whole video, then that will seem pretty benign and harmless and innocuous, I can assure you, for what I got planned tonight, actually. Once again, you, now you're probably thinking about me when you wrote this, must not do or admit to do anything which may weaken. Woo-hoo. You have no idea. You better not be in my head, dear Mr. World Nuclear Association. Damage or be detrimental to the World Nuclear Association trademark. Goodwill. You got no goodwill. And you are about to have your reputation definitely guttered. I'm going to drag your butts to the gutter. That's where you belong, in the gutter. You like, people are like lying, fabricating, maniacal like crazies.
Yeah, you guys. Football Association.
You guys are. These guys are crazy, man. There's a link below. Following a major earthquake, a 15-meter tsunami disabled the power supply. Well, actually, the earthquake broke the backs of all the nuclear power plants in Fukushima. It was actually 14 reactors in Japan that went into a holy crap mode. And there was many, many releases. So let's get started on some of that. And it cut the power supply. They're saying the tsunami disabled it. Well, the tsunami tore up 500 miles of coastline. It wasn't just Fukushima. It tore the highways off. It tore all the telephone poles. It tore down the flags on people's houses. All three cores largely melted in the first 3 days. Now, they just updated that this month. And that's kind of interesting. All three cores melted, but it's okay. Chernobyl, one-third the size of any of the reactors at Fukushima, it's hell broken loose. Chernobyl was a 30% meltdown. Fukushima's are, like they said, now they're still, are largely melted down. What do you mean? How do you get a nuclear core to largely, how is it you get 9,000 degree temperatures and everything else around it doesn't melt down? You guys want to work that one out and send it to me in a PDF file sometime? I want to see it. I want to do the numbers myself with my little green calculator. And the accident was rated a 7 due to the high radioactive releases over days 4 to 6. Whoa, back the trolley up. We're talking about 3 melted reactors. They're not like a firecracker where they went boom, boom, okay? And it was all over. But then, like, you got to realize that the WIP repository in New Mexico, Carlsbad, they had a truck fire and they evacuated for 9 days. For 9 days, and then they had a radiation release and they didn't have to go back down. Now, some people might say it wasn't a truck fire, it was a radiation release, but like everybody knows, trucks are the most dangerous thing imaginable. Al Qaeda is going to get one and get it up into space, and it's going to launch the truck down, and we're going to have to evacuate some country one of these days because of a Chevy or a Dodge or a Ford.
Well, especially a Chevy, seeing as they're having to recall another 8 million vehicles.
Right, yeah. They're going to compensate them too, right? I got that.
$1 million.
Did you see the social experiment? I'm not digressing. See the social experiment Facebook done 700,000 people?
What a bunch of...
Yeah, I put a video up today about Leo Laporte. Now, Laporte, they cover Facebook, right?
Yeah.
They cover everything. If Facebook farts, Laporte and your crew will run in and go, "Woo! That was Wonderbirds!" And they'll report on it. And they'll put blurbs and blobs and one-hour dissertations up on the internet about it because Facebook burped or farted or something, right? But so they've been following Facebook since the day it was conceived.
Yeah.
Literally. And some of their friends actually work alongside of them.
I didn't get it. What was their opinion today? We're digressing, but...
Yeah, we did, but we'll jump back over here in a second. Well, that was important because that's just one of many studies that are out there that they've done.
Yeah.
In a 2-year gap. Yeah. And the reason the study came out was because they published it.
Yeah.
And so it wasn't like Facebook said, "Hey, by the way, we've done a study." No. What happened was it got published, somebody read it and then blogged about it and then it went viral. Right?
Yep.
And so the study got published. They were like, "What the hell is this? Ho, landmine."
Yeah.
Because that's what it is. Let's jump back into that, though. But once again, you know, they were making people depressed and happy. They don't know if someone committed suicide because of that, right? And then they were checking back up on them the weeks later. But there was all kinds of other experiments going on at the same time. Yep. They hadn't been published yet, and they probably won't.
So right? What did Laporte say about it?
Leo,
yeah.
He said he wants to quit. He thinks it's disgusting, that it's stupid, that it's idiotic, yeah. that it's a betrayal, yeah. and that he wants to quit Facebook, but he uses it to beat them up anyway, yeah. right? for stupid stuff. And yeah, but I mean, they went for 9 minutes. They had a yeah. lawyer yeah. there, yeah. and yeah. they had an apologist yeah. there, and there was yeah.
That's all you. Sure, can, that's all you can do with Facebook now is use Facebook to beat up okay. face.
Yeah,
beat
it's up like, Facebook. Like it's like this. The last thing anybody should take away from all of this is that a corporation is corporate personhood. So Mark can go out and hack you and steal all your data. Say if I done it, I go to jail. He does it, he gets a fine, but he doesn't get a criminal record, right? He, you know, he's got no criminal record or anything like that. He don't personally get anything. The corporation, the entity with the personhood, and corporate personhood is an illegal amendment to the slavery law. And the slavery laws was an amendment to give the black people freedom from an oppressive, tyrannical government, and instead it's being used by corporations to enslave sovereign people. And so it's a, like a, it's, I know it's a tongue twister, but Justice Hugo Black wrote Eloquent Dissent in 1939 that it was absolutely absurd that corporations were using an amendment meant to free the oppressed people to enslave a sovereign people. So that's really significant what a corporation is doing, right? So they get a lot of the Fourth, Fifth, and they get a lot of the First Amendment. They got Second Amendments with their security. But anyway, back to the World Nuclear Association. Now, at their logo at the top of the page, they say, representing the people and organizations of global nuclear profession. And so they're in every aspect of the nuclear industry, the waste, and they know you can't put this stuff in a sarcophagus. They know because it releases the noble gases, and those sarcophagus will become landmines, grenades, right? And those fragments will you know, kill and harm and destroy the facilities. You won't be able to use the facilities. And so they release radioactive material into your community. All nuclear plants are releasing 120,000 liters out of their fuel pools every day. It's boiling off. Now, these guys can't tell the difference between a banana and a 12-foot fuel rod. These guys can't tell the difference between a potato chip and a 12-foot nuclear fuel rod. And so that's why we're here tonight. They, you know, they make these connotations where four reactors were written off due to damage in the accident. Have you ever seen pictures? There's two times. Well, the link's not there tonight. I forgot to get them in there because I had so much company. But I'll have the links in there as soon as the video's up. And there'll be 2,000 pictures down there you can download from TEPCO's website. They don't link you to those. They link you to the propaganda machine. But that's not the best. Here's one of the crazy things they say. There have been no deaths or cases of radiation sickness from the nuclear accident. Okay, that's an outrageous fabrication. It's an unbelievable, hideous omission. It's so egregious. Yeah, that they should lose any degrees they got. They should be, like, freedom of speech is not for popular speech. I get that, okay? Popular speech, it's the cliches, we hear it everywhere. Freedom of speech is for unpopular speech. For things that people don't want. They want to talk about football or baseball, and you want to talk about the 5 million orphans in Afghanistan. You want to talk about, you know, you say you support the troops, and people, yeah, you know, I'm patriotic, I got nationalism, I support the troops, rah, rah, rah. Well, what about the 23 veterans that committed suicide today? No one supported them. And that's 80,000 plus since the Vietnam, or since the Iraq War. But, you know, there's 280,000 rapes in the military. If they're raping their own that much in the last decade, how many they rape? That's reported. There's an estimated 28%. But if they're raping their own that much, how many they're raping in the countries they're occupying? If you occupy a country and you send in a bunch of rapists and they rape your loved ones and your daughters and your wives and your mothers, are you going to be the resistance? Of course you are. And so if you want to create resistance, you turn them into savages, you let them loose, with no rule of law, and then you let them rape everybody, and you, by proxy, create the animosity and the conflict itself, right? You come in and you fire depleted uranium rounds, and I mean, they fired 5.5 million rounds a month. I'm not digressing. I've depleted, half of that was from McAllister's. This was left over from the nuclear waste. They put it in the munitions, And there's over 2 million rounds a month. 20 train car loads. It's the equivalent in radiation of 166,000 Nagasaki bombs worth of radiation coming out of McAllister's bomb manufacturing facility, according to a Japanese physicist at a Humburn conference several years ago. When you do a tonnage, the A-10 Warthog ships nothing but depleted uranium-238 rounds, and that's contaminated with the americium, the neptunium, the plutoniums. They are truly dirty bombs. Every one of those are dirty bombs. Prince Harry in those Apache, that's all that shoots are dirty bombs. So Prince Harry was up there with pictures of him saving Afghanistan children, giving them cookies and chocolate bars. Nestle, by the way, Nestle chocolate bar, Nestle, products, they killed, back in the 50s, 1 million children a year with their baby formulas. Right, that's part of history. 1 million, and yet they're still out there selling chocolate bars that are full of aspartame and GMO critters and creatures. And I just went down a long path. But to say that there have been no deaths, and you're supposed to be the common sense where people go to. You're supposed to be the light at the end of the tunnel that's not a train coming to run you over. When you're actually a train, your light is the train at the end of the tunnel, because you're lying by saying there was no deaths or cases of radiation sickness. There was 5,000 TEPCO employees with 10,000 counts a minute. The streets there were 7 people died in the streets since Fukushima. Not that far in the Fukushima prefectures. We got schools where children are dropping dead with no explanations. Like, we got 40% of everybody visiting the hospitals in 2011 had massive high numbers of counts per minute under inside. If you add that up in one day, how many counts they get in one day? You know, like, you gain 10,000 counts a minute for the Fukushima workers, Roger. 10,000 counts a minute. Okay, that's a lot of counts, Dana. Well, yes, it is. But guess what? Let me count that over 60 minutes. And I'm too stupid to do it on top of my head. So 10,000 times 60. No. 10,000 is 600,000 counts an hour. So that's 600,000 hot particles. And that's going to be that every hour for the rest of your life till the tumors, you can't get your arms back down to the side of your body. These people will all die. Because radiation generally doesn't kill you right away. But that doesn't mean it won't strip the hair from your body and you'll puke and diarrhea like we've seen, right? But if you want to go down those headlines, I'm just going to go over and click on them. Hang on. Because I got a whole list of that stuff. It's a maniacal thing to say when you got the industry, am I documenting a genocide? File. There's a sweetie death filler. Heart attacks, radiation and illnesses. Oh, heart attacks. Fukushima worker has heart attack while working on reactor number 1, 31 years old. That's no big deal. Mainstream media articles. Next one is radiation around Fukushima on March the 14th, 2011, nearing levels where humans vomited uncontrollably and hair was stripped from the bodies. That was the Sun, March the 14th. Tokyo nuclear cloud crisis. 2 high school students die in the same school at once, February 26. Japanese discusses personal health problems, strange deaths. 7 people died on this particular shopping street, September 18, 2012. That probably wasn't Fukushima either, right? Reporter says he hears the ambulances coming to Fukushima plant at least 10 times a day, but everything's okay. Nobody got sick. It's all fine. 10 times a day. That's 3,650 times a year, Roger. Another Fukushima cleanup worker dies January 17, 2012. Birds that are unable to fly January 4, 2012. Some unable to read, top Tokyo doctor dealing with the nuclear workers. They can't even read. But they're not dying because we can't find them, right? They're homeless. There's no study. They're homeless. Underage people were employed. Cesium 137 immediately damages their heart muscles, not slow acting. A fireman dies after working in Fukushima after the quake, vomited blood, and died of a renal failure. 40% of Fukushima visitors shows internal exposure to radiation. And that headline, of course, shows that the World Nuclear Association never done any research. They never even tried, right? For them to come out and say, oh, you must not do or omit to do anything which may weaken, damage, or be detrimental to the World Nuclear Association trademark, goodwill, or reputation. I blew it. Oops. You should have told me earlier, man. No, for you guys to say there's been no deaths or cases of radiation sickness, right? You just got discredited. And so everything else you say is by proxy now discredited because you're supposed to be above reproach. You're supposed to be, you know, you got all these people from all the industries and you can't even get that right. You can't even make up a number like 10 people died. But to come out and say nobody died with 3 melted reactors and like that's the most...
Yeah. We know a bunch of them.
That is crazy talk. I mean, that is disgusting. Yeah. That they are the biggest people. Everybody's running to them all over the planet for information. And when you come down the article, this is the first thing you run into. Right? And so then you wonder why people like me, I don't want to be here. Nobody wants to be doing what we're doing. We're not supposed to. Our institutions that we paid to do the jobs. What they done was they turned off the EPA, turned off all the detectors. Canada took them all down, right? March 22nd, 23rd, 24th. Saanich, Victoria, Hawaii guy.
Yeah.
They took them all down, and then we never had no readings after. That's not what we paid for, right?
No.
Did we pay these people to go ahead and look for all that stuff? Did we give them all equipment, right? We gave them all the funding. We gave them the authority. We gave them airplanes. We gave them everything they ever wanted to go look for it. And instead what they do is they just keep raising the limits and say it don't exist. Yep. Well, why are you raising the limits?
Or shut it down and stop doing testing.
Yep. Right. And then I didn't say that people that are talking about it are fear-mongering when we're only here because we're forced to be here. We're not here because we want to be. There's no fun, no glory in doing this one, right?
No.
Like, I want to be a blogger to come out and pound down a few celebrities, beat up a few politicians, have a few say stupid shit, do stupid stuff. I don't want to be here doing this, but you got no choice because you turned the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution and they talk about bananas and they talk about walking in the sunshine and dental x-rays.
And potato chips.
And they got nothing to do with the man-made radioactive emitters, ionized alphas and betas and gammas. You know, they got nothing to do with it. But yet they keep saying that it does. And so we end up arguing with people that thinks it does and people get shocked when you find out that a banana has nothing to do with a 12-foot nuclear fuel rod. I know that's a shock. But I was shocked when I realized, when I found out that that 12-foot nuclear rod and a banana weren't the same. Like, I still don't know, right? I still cry myself to sleep. Hug my teddy bear every night, trying to get some solace because I believe the Lord.
No.
It hurt more than Santa Claus and the Easter Bunny together.
It can't be so.
I'll let you go.
I'm out of here. I'll see you later.
Okay, buddy.
Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye, everybody. So, there have been no deaths or cases of radiation sickness. See, I can't get over that one. But over 100,000 people had to be evacuated from their homes to ensure it. When you can't even decontaminate with battery acid. But government nervousness delays their return. So the government is the reason people can't go back. But the reason no one got sick is because they were evacuated. Do you got any idea what kind of twisted, demented couple of sentences those are? You can't put that, that's grammatically, like, I'm really bad, but that is terrible. That's unimaginably stupid. Whoever wrote that up should never be allowed to write or read a book again. They're dangerous. There's nothing you can do to help these people. They are totally beyond... And they're so caught up in themselves, they're so grandiose, they think they're so up and coming because they work for a mass murder machine. Fukushima, the Unit 3, is 2 million times worse than any other reactor on the planet. That makes it 18 million times worse than Chernobyl. Chernobyl is 3,500 square kilometers evacuated permanently till the end of time. But that's only because it's highly contaminated. outside of it should be evacuated too, because 12 to 50 becquerels will cause permanent lesions to your organs. They're looking at increasing levels to 1,000, 1,400 becquerels in North America in your food per kilogram. You bioaccumulate it every time you eat. Now, a banana is homeostasis. Look it up. And what that does, a banana is potassium 40, and that's not radioactive. You can go swimming in bananas, you're not going to get cancers, you're not going to see tumors on bananas, and bananas are not going to mutate fruit flies. And no matter what kind of fantasy world you live in, it just doesn't work that way. But if you put them alongside of man-made radioactive elements, ionized elements from the chain reaction, it'll mutate the crap out of fruit flies and you and your pets and everything else, and plants and everything else. That's man-made ionized radiation. All breast cancer has been traced to ionized man-made radiation. And I better come over and check to make sure I'm still streaming, because it's one of those days where I'm just, the stream didn't want to go, man. It was telling me, no, man. Yeah, still streaming. Oh, I'm sorry. Kicking a little bit. And how's everything going over here, folks? I got two thumbs down. We'd like to thank you for not having the patience of paying attention long enough to know that I don't lie, that I don't fabricate, that I don't misdirect, and that I only tell the truth because that's just the way it's supposed to be, and that we're forced to be. We can't even have a bit of fun. You know, we got to be serious all the time. We got to tell it like it is so that the community out there that might be able to change things has the ammunition, right? We're not here for something to do. Like everybody that's on this chat room tonight is not here for something to do. They're here because they understand the significance of what we're up against, and that if, you know, we together, we united, we stand, divided, we all hang separately. And that's why you'll find all those links below me consistently, constantly, and you always will. Of all these people, and there's so many more of them I can never fit in, but you know, it's just to try to, and you'll find them there too. It's just we need to support everybody, right? And I'm going to do my thing. As make no mistake about it, it's not a game to me. This is life and death for 8.8 million species on this planet, and they don't got a voice, and they need your voice. They need your support. They need your help. They need your attention. And it's not difficult for you to learn. Like if you look at a banana and you look at a 12-foot nuclear fuel rod, even you, right, who never went to university forever, you could probably figure it out and say, okay, well, they're probably not the same. If you painted the banana or painted the rod yellow, I could kind of lean towards, yeah, I can see how people can confuse a 12-foot nuclear fuel rod with a banana. Even though a fuel rod is only about as thick as your pinky, and a banana. You know, how come bananas are not kept in sarcophagus? Because they're not radioactive. Why are they used in the conversation to mock you and deceive you? So anybody that ever mentions the word banana is obviously very stupid. Or if they're actually educated, then they're obviously a lawyer. Or they're very gullible, extraordinarily gullible. But mostly there'll be a lawyer. If you see them in the media, they're only there because they're useful idiots and they're a PR and they know how to say things that pleases the nuclear the nuclear cartel, I guess is a better way of putting it. Because there's about 2 million industries dependent upon the nuclear for money. And they will murder everything on the planet in order to try to get another paycheck. They lie to their families. I'm getting digressing, but the nuclear industry is full of fabrication. Just like that fabrication of trying to claim that there have been no deaths or cases of radiation sickness and government nervousness delays their return. Well, let's cover that one. Let's cover that one for a second. Okay? Because I find that's really offensive to me. And let's cover that one. Why didn't Japan let the people move back into their communities? Okay, I'm going to start at, you know, in the first 100 hours after the quake, not that it ever stopped releasing radioactive material, there's 1,440 plumes every day. There's not just a plume that came out of Fukushima is going across the ocean. It's not just a plume that came out of Fukushima, went into the atmosphere, into the, You know, we got the studies on going 25,000 feet and 15,000 feet, 3 and 5 miles up. That's enough to get into the jet streams, to get sucked up into the jet streams. The particles at 1/10,000th of a millionth of a meter are much smaller than forest fires, are much smaller than smog in your city, yet that comes over North America, the Trans-Pacific, and adds to your pollution indexes in North America and lingers in your country. But there was spent fuel pools, 1, 2, and 3 started to boil in the first 100 hours. Now, the spent fuel pools are radiated, ionized elements. They've been through the chain reaction. They're just as bad as the reactors. The reactors were 3,450 assemblies in each reactor. Each assembly had 80 rods. Each rod is around 12 feet, and it's around 18 pounds. And it's around 600 times more radioactive atoms and elements than all the grains of sand on the planet. And there was 280,000 in each of the reactors, times 600. Now, if you liberated all the grains of sands and all the beaches on the planet into the environment with some voodoo stuff, you couldn't see each other. There's just so many particles there. Imagine 600 times that, floating around in your environment. Are you going to breathe any of that in? Probably so, right? Imagine 288 times 600. Imagine 3 melted reactors. Imagine 3 melted cores, meltdown, melt-throughs, half a mile down, miles down, nobody knows anymore. There's certainly, they never slowed down when they hit the topsoil. There's 100 foot of topsoil under the building. Once it got through the building, at 9,000 degrees, it'll consume everything. There's nothing. And they become radioactive particles. They are atoms. They become ionized radioactive atoms. And so when people try to tell you, oh, there was 970,000 petabecquerels of iodine-131, there was 10 times more iodine-132. And remember, half-life's are times 10. There was 10 times, 30 times more iodine-133. Remember, for every 3 iodine-131, there's an iodine-129 with a 15 million year half-life. Remember, half-life times 10. Remember that none of these isotopes travel by themselves. If you got cesium, there's 100 times more strontium. Let me go down the numbers for you. France says Japan has lost control. But the World Nuclear Association said, no, it's all fine. The Japanese government are just being big sissies. The government says 1,500 tons of highly radioactive sludge may end up as soil for gardening. Because they got so much they can't do anything with it. They got a couple of billion tons of radioactive material from just the tsunami and everything else washing through that place. And that they pile up because it's radioactive. 50,000 tons of sludge water at the treatment plants. You got to realize they're digging up the topsoil all over the prefectures, taking it to other prefectures, and grinding up and burning it in incinerators. Highly radioactive sewage found 30 miles from Fukushima plant. Cesium levels at 334,000 becquerels a kilogram. Well, let's do some math on that for everybody. Right fast here. So, 300, what's going on there, I wonder? Let me get rid of that. Try that one more time. And don't click things twice, Dana. Calculator. Okay, so 334,000, which three zeros, times, let me see, we'll go 100 for strontium 90. So wherever you got the cesium-137, there was 100 times strontium-90. Oh, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 33 million becquerels a kilogram of strontium-90 in that same one. Like, that will cook you. That will murder you. You will die if you got a kilogram of that stuff into you. Now, what you got to realize is that that's a kilogram. You want to get that in the cubic meter. Then we'll multiply it by around 26. So where your child stands up waiting for the bus in the prefectures, in those areas, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, will be 868 million becquerels. And so those children, you know, 40% of the population that went to the hospital, they stopped testing after a while. They put signs up at the hospital, we don't treat or test for radiation anymore. But over 43% had radiation emitters, counts per minute, high ones, man-made radioactive material, cancer in their body. And each of these isotopes will give you different types of cancers. But that's what I mean by the numbers, when you actually truly look at the numbers, because they just want to give you these same stupid numbers. Debris from Fukushima nuclear plant is being ground up and burned in other parts of Japan. CNN. That was January or November 8, 2012. Disposal of quake debris begins in Tokyo. Tokyo is over £1 billion. November the 4th. They're burning radioactive material is what they're talking about, see? £1 billion in Tokyo they scraped up. Because Tokyo, millions of becquerels everywhere. Per meter, it was nothing. Japan to burn drums of unprocessed radioactive waste from nuclear accident. Facility to be 100 kilometers from Tokyo. June the 26th, right? They're just going to burn it. It's supposed to be the sarcophagus till the end of time. Listen, you can put this stuff... You know, it's created in the bowels of hell. Burning it is just going to liberate the elements into the environment. It's an absolute betrayal of Earth, of humanity, of all the creatures on the planet to even consider doing that. That is the twistedest, the most dementedest thing possible. Fire them and get your institutions, your 4,340 peer-reviewed academic studies every day that are published, the 3 a minute, the 1,444, 40 minutes a day, to work on how to deal with this, instead of hiding it away behind Elsevier, Springer's, and Wiley's 20,000 academic ivory towers. They get the copyrights to all your university peer-reviewed studies. How come? So they can keep you at CNN, which is not news. It's commentary. It's conjectures. It's really bad stuff. These are people that are... PR machines. All your media is a PR machine. If you go look up any of your media personalities, and they all got a litany, a history of diplomas and degrees and accreditations and accolades of PR firms, PR courses and presentations. Local official, they found plutonium in every sample. Minnesota City Council. Iodine-131 detected in Tokyo, 350 becquerels a kilogram at the garbage facility. People are, garbage is just contaminated, see? But the sewage systems, they can't convert it over to fertilizer anymore because it's so radioactive. And they only check for cesium, they're not checking for uranium or plutonium or any of their daughters or the strontiums. Or they're not checking for the 2,800 man-made radiation elements. There's 260 natural ones, and there's close to 2,800 man-made radioactive materials that are not created by the sun, that are not found on the moon. You're not going to find them on Mars or Jupiter or anywhere that we know about in our solar system, because they don't show up on any of the periodic tables. They were added to it in order to try to make it look that way, but these elements are 100% man-made, and that's why they call them man-made radioactive elements. They don't say these are elements, they say these are man-made radioactive elements. See, wording is very important. Atlantic says on June 4, 2012, if government is trying to contaminate every region of Japan by burning radioactive debris, if everyone is contaminated, then in a relative sense, nobody is. And everyone's got the same, right? Incinerating radioactive material can contaminate the environment. Once again, you can incinerate it at 3,000 and 4,000 degrees. All you got to do is liberate the elements. If they get into you, you cremate your body after you die of the tumors, because a tumor is a sarcophagus. That's what your body reacts to, these man-made radioactive material. It's a sick, twisted joke how they say they're going to put them in a sarcophagus, when a sarcophagus actually, the only thing that can put them in a sarcophagus is a tumor. That's what a tumor is. It's a sarcophagus, because the elements, they get sequestered in your organs, sequestered in your bones, sequestered in your body, and you get these cancers, right? I can't take it anymore. I gotta smoke a puff on my cigarette. By the way, my cigarettes don't have 4,000 chemicals. What's that, Dina? Yeah, well, here's a quick story for you. When the EPA was created, they grandfathered in 65,000 chemicals in 1981 when they hung the shingle outside their door. And they had no environmental or human impact studies on it. And what that translates is, you can put 4,000 chemicals in a cigarette legally, because there was no environmental or human impact studies, doesn't mean you shouldn't have done it yourself. So somebody woke up one morning and said, hey, I got a great idea. Let's put 4,000 chemicals in a cigarette. But somebody else had another idea where they said, we're going to put a filter in a cigarette. Now, the filter makes the particles smaller and gets to the liner of your lungs, the membrane in your brain, right? And then you get tumors up there. But see how that works? You know, like if you Cheese Whiz, you ever eat Cheese Whiz? There's no cheese on that label. it's all man-made, right? There's around 2,000 chemicals that are labeled as food. And you can actually make a chocolate bar out of those chemicals with no chocolate, nothing else, and then call it a chocolate bar. Because your system is demented. It's twisted. And it always has been and always will be. It's vicious with power. And now, for some reason, to keep the job alive, because the whole world right now is going to be employed cleaning up radioactive material. That's the only industry left on this planet right now is nuclear. And it's going to destroy 8.8 million species on this planet. It's going to destroy the Pacific Ocean because you have 50 square miles a day for 1,100 days going into the ocean. You have a new plume of radioactive material every minute. You have 1,000 pounds of radioactive water minimum, if not 5,000 pounds of radioactive water a minute. It's 300 tons a day. There's 600 tons a day just pouring on the reactors. Perpetual motion machine. You can never stop that. You got to get off the site and you'll lose it. And 300 of that goes into the ocean. 300 of it gets pumped into the tank farms. 300 tons. 300 tons of that highly radioactive material that they spray on it. But underneath it, there's 1,000 to 4,000 tons of radioactive water, because the water has to pass under all the melted fissionable products, the detonations of the fuel rods, the release of reactor 3 ejected its fuel core right from the reactor, the 280,000 rods, the 3,450 assemblies were ejected all over the site, the plutonium and uraniums. But the pellets are fissionable products. They are splitting the atoms individually. These are this stuff, and what makes it so deadly is they took missiles from silos that should never ever go through a chain reaction again, because now they're 2 million times worse. The gammas, the betas, the neutrons, the x-rays are a couple of million times worse. If you do it again, they're a couple of million times worse again, times a couple of million. They're much more dangerous. That's why there's all this. That's why they have to wear these big suits. That's why they have these 50-mile evacuation zones. That's why, you know, they have all these emergency drills. That's why they have these, you know, the terrorists are going to get a dirty bomb. Meanwhile, and contaminate your city, you won't be able to live there no more. Meanwhile, you know, like a gram produces more radioactive atoms than all the grains of sands and all the beaches on the planet. And when you fire these depleted uranium munitions, you know, you're firing 5 million rounds, half of them were depleted uranium from McAllister, Oklahoma. That's all they do is make dirty bombs. They're all dirty bombs. Like I say, Prince Harry in his helicopter, is all he's doing is shooting dirty bombs. The industry, that's all it does. It tells you we lock it all up, we store it all. No, they make dirty bombs out of it, and they fire it into the impoverished people's countries. And don't think for a second that those radioactive ionized elements don't show up in the mountains, in the samples, and everywhere else. Don't think for a second the disposition from Fukushima has stopped. Don't think it's probably ever going to stop. And that's why they have to come out and say, there's nobody got radiation sickness. That, to me, is demented. That's what sent me down this path tonight. Fukushima plant will burn radioactive waste, incinerator to run around the clock. See, they're not supposed to do that. The NRC says, you're going to put it all in a sarcophagus, right? Yeah, that's right. Okay, give me my money. And so we can't trust these people. If anybody deserves to be hanged, it's these people that write and lie and steal and put the system here to protect these monsters, to empower these monsters, to destroy the other 8 million species on this planet so they can have a paycheck, so they can feel important. And they lie to their own family. They are manipulative beyond imagination in every sense of the word. Iodine 131 levels rise 350 kilometers from Fukushima at the sewage plant because people are going to the bathroom, and the fissionable products never came and stopped coming out of there hardcore until November. So April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November. It just hemorrhaged the entire planet. We got all the models from, let me keep going. But it wasn't just iodine 131, it was all the other elements. You can't have one without the other. If you got one, you got all the other. And so they weren't testing for the uranium, they weren't testing for the plutonium, they weren't testing for the strontium. But you give it another 5 or 10 years, and I can guarantee you, I won't have to make a video, because now the numbers will show up. Japan is burning Fukushima debris 10 miles from Daiichi nuclear plant. post-Fukushima horror, severe impacts on the oceanic environment, an unpredictable amount of damage to the Pacific, fundamental to reproduction of the humans. 3 billion people depend upon the Pacific. Japan's for fish. Japan's simply dumping the nuclear waste into the sea. They can't do anything else with it. They're bringing the homeless in there. Do you really think the homeless are all going to sit around? Come on, guys! We gotta know better! We're getting big bonuses! We got wives and families and big fancy cars! And we are treated like hotshot scientists! No, you're the homeless and they were shanghaied and then marginalized and thrown away like trash when they done the most heroic jobs imaginable, never knowing the contributions they done to this planet. They are the true heroes, not the zeros like the Kusus and the nuclear apologists and propagandists, not the mouthpieces and the maniacal representatives from our institutions who got the job because they are lobbyists. They were hired by lobbyists. All your universities are horrible, horrible, hideous nuclear scientists. They're all monsters. They all bought into the lie of E equals MC squared. But a banana is the same as a 12-foot nuclear rod and a potato chip. And give me my check. Give me my job as a professor, right? Like the professors I call here from CBC, Jay Cullen from the University of Victoria for the second time, and mouthpiece from University of Alberta, who equated man-made radioactive elements with potato chips. A sitting university professor, Dr. Tora, you know, find her name. YouTube got us all screwed with the new setups. Hard to find anything. Once again, you know, for that site to come out and say that nobody is hurt, nobody died. Let me read that for you one more time. There have been no deaths or cases of radiation sickness from the nuclear accident. Dana, stop it. The only reason people are not going back is because the government's nervousness delays their return, Dana. Come on, Dana, let it go. We need a job. We can't have a job, Dana, if you're out there telling everybody the truth. La, 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 Dana tells the truth. La, 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 la. Let me keep going for a few more for you. Massive radioactive waste buildup in Tokyo suburbs. My goodness, like 1 million becquerels a cubic meter is just normal all around Tokyo. They got 1 billion tons that they dug up to try to hide it from you. Tokyo officials blast the parents who want their kids to avoid ingesting radioactivity at school. It's important to share the pain. Well, that's why you can't get rid of at your sewage plants, just because the kids are eating so much of it and pooping it back out. First time since the meltdown, surge in radioactive cesium levels caused incinerators near Tokyo to shut down because there's so much radioactivity coming out of those incinerators. But a lot of that will find its way, of course, right across North America in 3 days' time at 100 miles an hour in jet streams, because these particles are so tiny, you re-liberated them. Once you gathered them up, see, what they done after Chernobyl was use helicopters and they sprayed these regions and they knocked the radioactive material down. And then they come in and they bulldozed it all in the pits and try to contain it a little bit. I mean, yeah, it's still going in the groundwater. It's still going to liberate eventually. But what they done in Japan was they done 5,000 studies in the first 90 days or something, and they never told the public. They never told them nothing. They just kept it all a secret. Radioactive fallout around Fukushima incinerator plants being hidden is very odd, reports from Japan. Tokyo neighborhood cesium approaching levels found in Fukushima, 70,000 becquerels a kilogram. Well, if you got 70,000 becquerels of cesium a kilogram, you got to put another two zeros on that. Right? So you put another two zeros on it, and you got 1, 2, 3. You got 7 million becquerels a kilogram of strontium 90. That was Ken Buesler's words too, but I got it from other sources too. U.S. to burn hundreds of tons of radioactive waste, so did he, from Germany and Tennessee. See, that's how twisted the whole bloody thing is. It's so disgusting what they have got done to our planet, from barrels dumped into the ocean with trillions of becquerels, disintegration, atomic decays a second, rotted away on our ocean floor, because they were able to scam and make money that way. They were able to hide it away from you, and you will never hold them accountable because you will never know about it. Remember, we covered almost 700 nuclear accidents in my Nuclear Earth series, and I still have one video left to go, the number 7 video. And these are 1-hour videos about all the nuclear, maniacal, crazy, demented stuff that the industry does. Like 800 pregnant women, Stanford and other institutions, went to a local hospital and injected pregnant women, told them it was vitamin drinks, vitamin injections, and made them drink orally, radio, and including children too. This was done to them, but it was radioactive cesium and plutonium and uraniums. And then they would dig up their corpses after they died of cancer and study it. Against the family, not even tell the family. Yeah, I don't smoke a whole cigarette. I have a few puffs and kill it, because it's not addictive like a typical cigarette is. I don't have 4,000 chemicals. No filters. U.S. to burn the thousands. Fukushima will start burning radioactive waste. 100,000 becquerels a kilogram. And they got 1 billion pounds of debris in the exclusion zone, right, to get rid of. And 100,000 becquerels a kilogram. That's a dirty bomb. If you had a kilogram and you blew it up with a firecracker, that's a dirty bomb, right? That's the very, very definition. That's man-made ionized radioactive material. That's a dirty bomb. That's worse than a dirty bomb. That's disgusting. But TEPCO said that if you've got radioactive material on your property, it's yours. And properties there with like 1 million becquerels per second. Not counting, that's just a cesium. You don't even know how to look for plutonium. You don't even know how to calibrate your Geiger counters for the worst stuff. You can't even find it with the Geiger counters. You need hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of equipment. Sorry. One last puff. Here we go. Starting to the wind down. Mysterious black substances has 1 million plus becquerels a kilogram of cesium. Well, then it's 100 million of strontium. Then there's a couple of million of uranium, a couple of million probably of plutonium. Certainly millions and millions and millions of all the other radioactive ionized elements. And let me cover a couple more headlines from the other batch for us. 40% of Fukushima visitors show internal exposure to radiation. Does that qualify? Is the question we got here tonight. Does that qualify? Does that change the tune of the World Nuclear Association by saying there's been no deaths or causes of radiation sickness from the nuclear accident at Fukushima, right? So once again, they're completely discredited immediately. As you read down to that whole page, links below, everything they say is a fabrication. I mean, they use TEPCO as a source. If someone uses TEPCO as a source, they're literally friggin' stupid in the sense of because they never fact check what they said. You gotta fact check whatever TEPCO says. Now, after this video gets up there, I'll post all the links below again, because I do that sometimes if I forget to get them in there. And I'm pretty sure I forgot tonight. But you'll see a link there for over 2,000 pictures. You can download 99 lots. And you don't need to go read or watch this. You go look at those pictures. They'll tell you everything you need to know. They're from the Fukushima 50. I mean, over 1,000 nuclear workers. 10,000 counts a minute after visiting Fukushima. May 23rd, 2011. The Machini, May 21st, 2011. After working in an affected area, 4 workers have died, victims of leukemias or heart attacks. But we seem to have come out and say a heart attack, that's not radiation sickness. No, strontium or cesium goes smack into your heart. It sequesters right into the organ itself. And that's what it does. You know, go look up Dr. Raymond Gilmedy from Loveless. He fed plutonium to beagles, puppies, and dogs. For almost 4 decades, murdered them, then done autopsies on them. He got 84 studies. I covered it on this site, a bunch of those studies. But if you take plutonium, it's not going to kill you in the tiniest amount. You should go interview Dr. Mass Murderer and Puppy Mass Factory Murderer Raymond Gilmedy from Loveless, New Mexico. And I mean, you take it to New Mexico, it could go down in the mine for 9 days because he had a truck fire. Right? That's your nuclear industry, see? They had a radiation release, everybody got radiated, and then they said 9 days later, oh, by the way, there's a radiation release, but it never started until the day. But we never went down in the mine for the last 9 days because we had a truck fire. And of course, truck fires are so freaking dangerous, you can't go down there, right? They're the scariest thing on the planet. They're more terrifying than a giant gecko. Report indicates five Fukushima workers have most likely received a fatal dose of radiation, the NRC transcript. And underneath my video after, you'll find a couple of million emails from the NRC and TEPCO and the official government site. There's a lot of redacted there, but that's one of them. Five Fukushima workers most likely received a fatal dose. That's sugarcoating it, trust me. They swallowed radioactive water, unimaginably radioactive. February 22nd, 2012, Informable. Put that story out there. Report, workers die while decontaminating in Fukushima, October 11th. But according to the World Nuclear Association, nobody died. Dana, no, like I say, Dana, leave it alone, Dana. We make a lot of money for lying and murdering everybody, Dana. We're just mass murderers, like everybody else, Dana. We're the World Nuclear Association.org. We're the good guys, Dana. Nobody died in Fukushima, Dana. You're just making stuff up, Dana. All the media is just being bullies. They're all fabricators, Dana. Japanese author. Extreme increase of mortality caused by cardiac disease in Fukushima. Death rate might give the creeps to some people. But nobody got hurt, Dana. It went from... The number of deaths was up from 12.5%. Compared to the same, 12,695 extra people died of heart attacks in that study. No, Dana, that's normal. We have mass die-offs all the time. They were just people scared and they died of heart attacks, Dana, because people scared them. Fukushima Daiichi worker dies. I've been preparing cover for unit number 3. But according to the World Nuclear Association, nobody died. So all these people are liars. That was TEPCO press release. So according to the World Nuclear Association, TEPCO's press release of a worker dying while working on the cover of Unit 3 is a liar and should be strung up and hung, not them. That's TEPCO's press release. And you couldn't even find that. Nope, Dana, nobody died, Dana. Nobody even got sick, Dana. No. And so why should I respect you? Why shouldn't I, have utter disgust and contempt for you? Because that's what I do. And that's what everybody should have for you. Everybody should go to your site, go down to the bottom of it. On the bottom right-hand side, you'll see contact. Click on that link and then go and tell them at their email addresses that you think they are mass murderers because they lie about that on their site and they need to correct that. And they need to go jump off the top of one of the reactors because they're mass murderers. Japanese government looking for kamikaze decontamination workers for the Fukushima prefecture. Job advertisement posted for the Ministry of Environment. Without decontamination, there will be no recovery of Fukushima. You can't even decontaminate with battery acid. You get it on your hands, even battery acid won't get rid of it. That's the reality of it. And not only that, you'll liberate it back into the environment and you just got a really serious burn. I took it to mean, therefore, there would be no recovery of Fukushima, but that's clearly not what the Ministry of Environment has in mind. The job advertisement posted. You know, Japanese medical expert, 51% of the kids are contaminated with cesium-137 at the Fukushima hospital, hot grandma particles. But no, Dana, nobody died, and nobody's going to get illnesses, Dana. Nobody got sick. We're the World Nuclear Association, and we checked it all out, and we have members. We control 95% of the world nuclear narrative, and we're saying nothing happened. So what their narrative is for media to go there, look for the answer to the question they want to have, and say, well, the World Nuclear Association says nobody died and nobody got sickness. And instead of doing some fact checking and saying, well, the World Nuclear Association was actually wrong, all these people died, and there was 51% of the kids at a hospital were contaminated with cesium-137 emitters inside of them, and they would have had 100 times more inside of them. But that was just the kids that went there. So the whole country is radioactive, right? Radiation health specialists. Children with over 11 becquerels a kilogram of cesium start to see heart problems. And in their article, they were saying how it's okay because you allowed 500 becquerels of cesium in rice. There's no safe limit. One becquerel in your rice is too much. The reason is 500 because the whole country is contaminated. and they're trying to go on with it instead of trying to deal with it. Instead of trying to take 4,340 peer-reviewed academic studies for a single day and try to solve some of the issues, they turn their back on you, they roll out the PR and the smear machine and the demonization machine and the marginalization military-industrial weaponized machine to attack everybody and to cut off the communications. I lost another 300 subscribers in the last couple of days. That's 4,500 now. And, you know, 5 million viewers gone from my site. 4,500 subscribers at least gone from my site. Just jacked in lots of 300s and 500s over the last year and a half. But in the last couple of weeks, that's 600 subscribers jacked from my site. Not that it's going to change anything. Not that that's going to stop me. You know, my site is up. I thought today was a holiday because it was Canada Day, but it's just the last day of the month. The holiday's not till tomorrow. And so I messed up today. And hopefully we can have the new Warrior Cast and everything up by the end of the week. If not, by Monday I'll have it all up and running. And then we're going to put some hurt into these people. Then the truth will come out really hardcore every day. I'll do a lot of 3 or 4 minute videos. I'll come over and say goodnight to everybody. Once again, radiation health specialists, children with over 11 becquerels a kilogram of cesium start to see heart problems. At 50, you're going to see permanent lesions to your organs living in that environment. We're all living in that environment. Expect to see all kinds of Alzheimer's, autoimmune deficiencies, diabetes, all kinds of thyroid issues, all kinds of medical issues. Remember, stay away from genetically modified critters. 90% of everything out there now is genetically modified product into it, except for Ben and Jerry. Grandma Goldie was going to share some with me. And remember that DCA, there's a link below. There's no pharmacy needed for it. There's no prescription. There's no patent on this. It's a harmless mineral. You go to a compound chemist in your community and you can get it. You don't need a prescription. And it reduced all cancer tumors by 70% in the first 3 weeks. Remember, turmeric has 600 peer-reviewed academic studies. Remember, dandelion root tea and dandelion itself has every mineral, micro, and macro nutrient your body ever craved. Remember, natural food doesn't have, well, think about corn. GMO corn, you have to eat 425 GMO corn on the cobs to get the same amount of calcium, potassium, magnesium as a single organic corn on the cob. And remember, organic doesn't have formaldehydes and glyphosate engineered into it. It doesn't have it. GMO products, all Kraft products, all GMO products have these dioxins and toxins engineered directly into the DNA of it. You can't eat that. That fuels the cancers on top of that. Cancers take 5, 10, 15 years to manifest, to show up to the point where you start to liquidate your assets to try to get comfort and extend your life. But no radiation. 2% of leukemia patients survive. 2% would survive anyway. It wasn't being treated by protons that made them survive. They were just the lucky ones. Okay, we'll come in and say goodnight to everybody. Have I got one more headline? Nearly 5,000 nuclear plant workers suffering internal radiation exposure after visiting Fukushima. But according to the World Nuclear Association, nobody got illnesses, including those 5,000 employees. So yet they represent those same employees, allegedly, and they turned their backs on them. Right? So they're a fabrication, they're part of the machine, and their job is to make people doubt what you're the truth, right? To come out and say, oh, no, you know, nothing happened. No, it's okay. It's just 3 melted reactors. They're okay. They stopped everything. They never stopped leaking into the ocean. Every day, it'll never stop. It's hemorrhaging into the ocean 50 square miles a day, every day. That's 1.8 million miles in the last 1,200 days. Okay, good night, everybody. Stacy, I see you're busy, busy. We send you extra hugs. And we appreciate everything you do. I know you put a whole lot of work into your site there, and that's so appreciated. And your links are below. Checks and Balances, Roosevelt, Irina Rill, Annabeck, hi sweetie, and Thirst, Ben and Jerry for president, I agree, Pasha, Burnsmill, Foggy Range, MSVS, Who did I meet? Albert, anybody? Mr. I Can See. Jackson, Jason, James, MSVS, Chris, Craig, Chex, Kate. Once again, Kate's links are below. Hugs for Kate. Hugs on A, yeah. Thank you. DJ, Bits, Roosevelt, Nep Killer, Punisher. Who else did I forget? Yeah. Okay, I'll wait for a few names to roll up, and then I'll click off, and we'll call it a night. Because when I put my cursor over, it takes a few seconds for it to start rolling. Here we go. Adam, Stacy, Ronald, Bob, MSVS, Mass Sterilization, Toxie, Alex, Smith, Bert, Stacy. That's better, see? Good night, everybody. Klondykes, see, Adam's got your name right. Toxie, Kevin, Irina Rill, War Prophet. Mass sterilization again. I'm starting to repeat myself. Punishers. Yeah, good night stuff. You're welcome. And thank you for participating. We'll be, once I get the computer up and running, the 8 core. I am going to have the 8 core after all. I changed my mind again. And the full wire cast. And I'll be able to help the green screens and everything. Will be no issues right away. So by next week, it'll be a lot of fun, each one of the streams. And there'll be a video of me in the streams too, right? With all the information, all the charts, all the maps. They'll be high quality too. And not tomorrow, but the next day, I'm going to goose up my internet connection to the highs I can get. And so that I can get a really high one here because I'm fiber. And so I'll be able to stream you super high with that 8 core. And we're really going to stick it to these folks. Really going to be doing it. Then we're going 24/7. And then we're going to start doing the interviews and everything else. Chris Cashin, Brita Youngie, everybody else. Serge, good night, everybody. Look at you folks on the rebound. And that hopefully will be tomorrow night because, well, tomorrow's Canada Day, so it's hard to say.